My name is Jordan Green, and my lab at Johns Hopkins is really interested in how we can develop new types of technologies to treat devastating brain cancers that even with the best surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation, still has poor patient outcomes. We've now developed a new technology that has a promise for treating this disease in a new way. The challenge with brain cancer and cancer broadly is that cancer cells were once upon a time normal cells have now mutated and grow uncontrollably. Here, let's see what we have in the toy box here, some dominoes. We can illustrate this concept. So if we have some normal cells, these are these black dominoes here, and cells are arranged next to each other in the body. They're normal and they're happy, but what could happen is there could be mutations that part of it could be genetic, part of it could be environmental, where some of them change into these cancer cells with different colors that aren't normal. And now you have these cancer cells and you also have healthy cells. And the way conventional chemotherapy works is it can't really tell a difference between a healthy cell and a cancer cell. It's really a poison, a toxin that'll kill everything. So if the cancer chemotherapy comes through, it'll kill your healthy cells and get your cancer cells. And this is why patients might lose their hair and have nausea and all these other complications. And so what we'd like to do is to attack just those cancer cells and not hurt healthy cells. Let's imagine that these balloons are cells. So we've developed a technology to send instructions to these cells to get them to do whatever we want. This is a little bit like how an electrical engineer could program a computer. As a biomedical engineer, we want to program cells. And we especially want to program cancer cells differently than healthy cells. This is our mission impossible. We were able to use this new technology to deliver our instructions to cells to make them change shape or color. And using the same type of technology, we can actually have the brain cancer cells self-destruct altogether. This approach is called gene therapy. The instructions that got the cancer cells to do what we wanted them to do, those instructions come from a nanoparticle, which is a particle made up of plastic and DNA. And it's about a million times smaller than this particle here, and the DNA is inside of it. And what it does is it can safely deliver this cargo through the different barriers and then let that information go to the right cell. The cell does what we want. We've demonstrated this now in human brain cancer cells in a dish and in live mice. And we're really excited about the next steps as we move this forward to patients. This type of discovery is possible here at Hopkins due to the natural collaborative atmosphere, where myself as a biomedical engineer, I can work closely with excellent neurosurgeons, and together as a team, we can innovate these new technologies that can make an impact to patients.